So in continuing the last session, continuation with the last session, we will extend the code that we left that we used in the last session for developing a frame. So I guess it was UI frame. Is screen visible? Okay, the one important point is mark this URL. The URL that I've used for the session, you must have seen that I am not changing the URL. So I guess you people should keep this URL with you, and whenever our session time is, you should join the URL without waiting for my information or my confirmation from me. So what has happened is, like today, I was not able to have a range on my mobile phone, as well as I was not able to access the WhatsApp on my PC because the mobile wasn't connected. I wasn't able to share the URL one more time. So if this scenario happens, you people should join the URL, because I'm using the personal meeting rooms URL, and the URL doesn't change. It remains same. So let's continue with our last session discussion. This is the code that we have used in the last session, right? And we have seen both the buttons, button one and button two, working fine. Let me use Java C UI screen Java. We'll compile it one more time and we'll execute it. Are you people able to see the output and the program, gedit and the program? Okay, fine. So now button one and button two is working. So let me close this. Now what we will do is, I'll just put a comment on this set layout option. We have seen this layout option in the last session because we wanted to add two buttons in the control and we wanted to use them. Now what will happen if I just do not use this set layout option? And if this we will leave the frame and Java to handle the UI management on their own, and if we compile the program, so let's see what happens if we do not add that layout option in the program. So I'll compile program one time and let's execute it. Now here you can see that the entire frame is acquired by the button two. And if I click on this, we will get the output as button two in a continuous manner. And button one, whether button one is added to the frame or not, yes, button one is added to the frame. But what has happened is, button one has also acquired the entire frame, and button two has also acquired the entire frame for display purpose. So as button one first, we have added, now if we look at the code, you can see that we have added button one for the first time. So what happened is the Java created a frame, then it created a button one, then it added action listener to the button one. Then this button one is added to the frame. After that, when we add this button one, as there is no layout manager used, right now we are not using any layout manager. So what happened is the button one acquired the entire surface of frame. Then what we are doing is we are creating a button two. Is my screen visible? And so voice is too low. Okay. Is my screen visible to you? Yes. Okay, fine. So do one thing. What happened is right now I'm using a Ubuntu system. So when I share the screen, I'm not able to see the chat box. So if there is any issue, technical issue with the environment, please unmute. Somebody must unmute and tell me what is the problem, because when I go to the gedit and terminal, then I'm not able to see the chat window. Again, because I'm using a Debian system, I'm not able to bring out the chat window out of the frame control. So when I minimize this browser window, I'm not able to see the messages on the chat. So if it is very important thing, then please unmute yourself and tell me what is the issue. Fine. Okay. Now when we added button two acquired the entire frame, right? And so we are not able to see where is the button one. And if I click on this, the output will come as button two. And there is no scope that we can use button one. Now let's do small tweaks with the program source code and see what effect it takes. Now what we will do is we will take this button two code and we'll paste it above the one, right? And now if I compile the entire program, again, one more time, if we compile the program and if we run this, now we have button one on the screen. So there is no scope for button two to get appear on the screen and show the output. So this is how Java adds the last control, and the last control acquires the entire frame. So it's of no use for us. Now,
hello sir, you are not audible.
Okay, my system is not showing the effect, but I'm sure that you can try this on your computer. What happens is, if we are making the frame visible for the first time, then you may get an inconsistent UI. Now, what is the meaning of inconsistent UI? So what we are doing right now is we are making the frame visible for the first time. Like the program runs and the first thing you are doing is you are making the frame visible. The second thing what we are doing is we are adding a button B1. and then we are adding button B2. So many times what happen is, if you make your frame visible at a very first time in the control or in the constructor, the first thing that you are executing is a setting up the size of the frame and setting up the visibility of the frame. Then you may see that the frame gets created, but the controls, all the controls that you want to add to the frame are not added, or even it means that layout manager is not doing a correct job. So if this thing happens, it is not because there is a problem with the environment or something. It is because your frame has been set visible before all the components are added. So we will make sure that the frame visibility code goes at the bottom of the constructor. So the very three line, these three lines, it is always recommended that these three lines will be the last lines in the constructor of creating a frame. Like this dot set size, this dot set visible, this dot set default close operation. So these three lines has to be the last lines in the constructor. Okay. So that is a very important point. Now we will add one more control called as J text field. I'll call it as TXT. Now let's initialize this and add it to the frame. TXT is equal to new J field. Now this integer or this number, which is an argument to the constructor, what it means is the text field should be created 10 columns. Now see the program in where I'm typing the program right now using a gedit. So this is also a text control, but this text field is a very same like you people have used in the website while typing your email address, while providing your password, or while filling out some form. Maybe on the desktop application you have used many programs which accept your name and profile details while registering the software. So that control is called as a text field. Now in the same way, like button was the control in the AWT and J button is the control in the swing, in the similar grounds, text field is the control from AWT and the J text field is controlled from the swing family. Now what we are doing is we have created a text field. Now let's add this text field to the frame. So this dot add .add.txt. Okay, so now let's see what happens when we compile and run the program. So okay, I haven't used the layout manager. Let me add the layout manager one more time. So I have three components on the frame and I'm using a flow layout to align the things on my screen. Now I'll again compile the program and I'll run this, and we will see that there are three controls in the program. Now here I'll be able to type the text that I want. Now this is the text field. Similarly, there is another control which is similar to the text field. Let me terminate this. Control C. Okay, I guess some error. Okay, so program terminated. Now, text field can accept one row. Now there is another control called as text area. Let me call it as TXT A. Now if we add this text area to the frame, let's do it. TXT A is equal to new J text area. And now I'm going to pass two arguments, the number of columns and then the number of rows. So this control is going to have 10 rows and 10 columns, and we can add this control to the frame. This dot add txt. Now if I compile the program and execute it, now you can find that text area is available. Now I can press enter key and add the text on multiple lines. With the text field, it is not possible to add multiple lines. Now, if what I'm doing is I'm typing some text and pressing enter key. And as you can see that, as there is only one row, I'm not able to utilize my control key option in the text field. Whereas in the text area, you can add, now I'm provided 10 rows in the control. Let's count that, whether I'll be able to grow after 10th row or not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. As you can see that already the control has expanded, right? So text area will allow us to add multiple rows typing. So multiple rows are available. And columns, by default there will be 10 columns, but if you keep on typing, the control will expand. And why this is allowed is we have used something called as a flow layout. Now this will have a different implication if we are using different layout managers in the Java environment. Now let's explore some of the other layout managers and how the controls will be managed if we are using some other layout manager environment. Okay. Each screen is visible. Hello. Okay. Whatever I have explained, have you people heard those things? So my voice was not audible. I've received one message in the private chat that my audio is not coming clear. So whatever I've discussed, you people have got it? Yeah, okay, fine. Okay. Now let's use some another layout managers. Now before changing the layout manager, I will try the thing one more time, like making the frame visible before adding any content to the frame. Let me do it. Let me take this control and let me add it. So what I'm doing is, again, I'm making the frame visible before even any controls components are added to the frame. Okay, fine, it is managing. Okay, one thing has happened. See the code. Okay. So it is a good time to see this. So I am sure that you people can see that there is a text area in my program, right? And if you see the UI, the text area is not added to the frame. Can you see this? Immediate replies in the chat window. Can you see this effect that in the code, you can see that there is a text area control added to the frame, but right now our output is not showing the text area. Right. So why this happened is because what we have done in the coding is we have set our frame visible for the first time. So what we are doing is, in the main, the program started execution. The first thing we are doing in the main method is we are calling the constructor by creating object of UI frame class. So obviously the constructor execution started. The first thing we are doing in the constructor is we are setting the size for the frame, which is 399. The second line is set visibility true. And then we are setting a default close operation. Then we are setting the layout. And then we have added control 1, control 2, control 3, and control 4. But there are only 3 controls that have appeared on the frame. This happened because the Java, what is expected by this UI environment is UI environment first puts all the control on the frame and then it shows the frame to the user. And we are doing something contrary to it. What we are doing is we are showing the frame to the user and then we are putting the controls on the frame. So if you people bring out some high speed camera, I don't know when it will be able to see. So if you follow this practice of setting the frame visible at the top of the constructor, then soon, like we are going to write some heavy programs with the UI, like we are going to create some pretty good applications, which will communicate, like, for example, creating a chatting application, creating a server which will send and receive a file between two clients and all this kind of application, or TCP client server, UI based TCP client and server. And if you make your feasible, in these programs, if you make your frame visible at the first time, or like as soon as your code execution start, you, the first thing you are doing is set the visibility true. Then I'm sure that most of you people will see that the control. Am I audible? So I'll repeat the story, that entire line that I said. Okay, let me close the window. Let me run the program. Now see that there is one control missing. The control which is missing is, in my frame, I have text area. There are four controls that we have added, which is button one, button two, button two buttons, one text field and one text area. What output we are getting on the other hand is we are getting only button one and button two. Now this is even a different output from the earlier scenario, right? So one control is missing. Now there are two controls missing on the frame. One is the text field and the other is text area. But if you look at the code, actually the controls are created, like we have created text a field as well as text area, and both are added to the frame also. Now why we are seeing this effect is, if we do it like we create object of the frame class, and then the first thing that we are doing in the constructor is we are setting the size and then we are setting the frame as visible. So what happens is Java creates a frame and then it starts adding the controls to the frame. Now this is not an expected thing. Like what will happen is, if your system is a bit slow or there are many controls on the frame, then literally the user will see the components getting added to the frame one by one. The user will be able to see that, okay, button one is added, now button two is added, now the text box is coming, now the text area is coming and all. So that is not a good program. So it is always recommended to set these two, three lines, like setting the size, setting the frame visible, and the default close operation. So these three things must go at the bottom of the gedit, or at the bottom of your constructor. So these three lines must be put at the end of the constructor, not at the top of the constructor. If you put these three lines at the top of the constructor, some controls will get missing. So I'm sure that you can see that the text field is not there as well as text area is not there. So if I stretch this frame a bit, let me do it. Picking up the side controls, the text area and the text field got added. Did you see that? Okay, good. So what happened is, when we people executed the frame and the UI got placed on the screen, and when we stretched this frame, the frame UI got refreshed. As soon as the frame UI got refreshed, the components which were not visible got added to the frame, and now we can use them, right? So if I do it, now I'm able to use the control text area as well as I'm able to use text field. Okay, now let me close the frame. Now let me take out these three lines which are at the top of the frame, and I'll put those lines at the bottom. Now I'll save it again one more time, and now if we compile and run, there will be no problem in displaying the output. The text field is there, text area is there, and all the controls, all the, we added totally four controls. So all four controls are available in the program. So this is a very important thing, that make sure that this should be, must be the last lines in the constructor. Let's make use of these two text fields and one text field and one text area that we have added to the program. Now, what we are doing is we are able to use them. We are able to use them. Is screen visible? Yeah, okay, fine. So we are able to use these controls. What we can, what we'll do is we'll create a program, we'll copy the text from text field, and it will add it to the text area. It will add it to the text area. So let's do that program. So now, where is my terminal? Okay, fine. So, and this is the gedit. So, what we'll do is, let's rename this button one. Let's rename this button one as copy. Is voice audible to you people? So yeah, there is a lot of technical trouble happening today. So what I'll do is even if this lecture continues, I'll repeat all this part, whatever I'm teaching one more time during our lab session. No issue. If somebody has missed it, no problem. So what I was talking, I hope, did you get the part that I've showed you, like how the text control text area was not added to the frame, and when we stretch the frame a bit, when we change the size of the frame by dragging it, the controls were visible. Did you see that effect? Okay, fine. Now the next, what I was saying next was, we have seen how to, what we are going to do is, we are going to create a program which will the text from one component to the other component. Now this is my frame. What I'll do is I'll rename this button one as a copy button, and I'll type something in the text field, and I'll click on this copy button, and the data will come into the text area. That is what we are trying to do. Now let me close this. For that, we have renamed the button one as this as a copy button. So let's do it. Button one will be copy button. Now what we can, how we can do is, now we are using something called as action command. A is the object of action event. So how this thing works is, when you say add action listener and button one dot add action listener and then this dot add button one, that time when we click the button and that event has been cached by action event class, AE class, and that AE is an object. Now this AE have variety of options using which it can identify which control. Right now we have four controls on the frame. Out of four controls, which control is responsible for generating the event? That can be identified by using this AE object. Now AE object have one option which is called as get action command. Now we have used that option in the last session, and right now also I'm using. Now the second way of doing is, the AE object or the action event object have one more method called as get source. Now there is the difference in the get action command and get source option. What is the difference? Get action command returns the string, and get source returns the object reference. Now what it means? Reference, we have seen that reference means the address of the object, right? The memory pointer in the main memory. So when we created a b1 is equal to new button and the string has been passed for a label, that time one object is created, one memory is reserved in random access memory or in main memory. And that memory location have some address. That address is actually stored in this variable called as b1. So what this b1 points to is, this b1 is pointing to a reference in the main memory. When we click on this button b1, using this get source command, we can get that reference. Now, if we are able to get the reference, that means the pointer or the memory area where the actual button is and who have generated the event, we can compare it. Now, what I can do is, I can write here, hello. See, I've received one more message on the private window that my voice is not audible. Am I audible? Are you able to see the screen or not? Okay, fine. Let me continue. So this reference is available in the B1. Now what I can do is, here, object. O1 is equal to here. What we can see is button one. Now what we are doing is, we are getting the source, ae.getSource will return the reference from the main memory. We are typecasting. If we don't typecast it, let me remove this typecast. Now we have seen this for the many time during the last sessions, like every class in the Java is somehow getting linked to the base class of programming language, which is capital O object. So what happens is, this ae.getSource returns the reference. Now this reference will be of type base class type object, because what is this B1? This B1 is an object of button class, right? Now this again, button class is a class in a Java. That means it has a relation with the base class of Java, which is object. So that means this button B1 is inheriting from or getting a relation with base class of Java, which is an object. Now a dot gate source returns the reference of b1, returns the reference of b1, and then we are able to get that reference into the o1 and we can use it. Now instead of using se dot command, cmd dot equals here copy option, what we can do is if let's say o1 dot equals b1. Now see, this everything is same here. We use action command, the string message, to compare two things. One is, the first thing is copy message, which is a string with the label, actual label of the button. And now here I am using this o1 dot equals. Now what is the o1? o1 is going to keep the source reference of actual button, which is b1. Now if the address of b1 and address of o1 gets matched, then the if block will execute. Now what we'll do is, inside this block we'll write, let me create a string, let's say message is equal to, our control name of the text field is txt, so I'll use txt. So I'm using a control called as txt.getText. txt.getText. Now, message string will contain the data which was in the txt text field. Now, what we can do is txta.setTextField and pass the string message. Now, what will happen is, if button one is clicked. Data of text field will get copied into the message, and then we are pasting the same text into the text area. That is what we are doing in this code. Now if button one is not clicked, that means obviously the button two may have been clicked. So what we can do is o1 dot equals, and here I can type button two. And so let's try this program. Let's try this. What happens? Let me compile. Okay. So let's execute this program. Now you can see that there is something called as a GOptionPane.showMessage dialog. We will talk about what are those options in a moment, but let's first check out the execution of the program. So UI frame. Now I will type the message, some string here. Let me type here as Kolhapur or the city name. And let me click on the copy option. Now I am sure that you people have seen this. Kolhapur is added to the text area from the text field. Now, if I click it one more time, nothing will happen. Now, what if we want to append to the data we will append the data to the text area. Now let me click on button 2. Now one message come. This message is, this is button 2 and not copy button. So one window has opened, and in this window the message has, the warning message has come, like message box, here is the symbol, and the message says this is the button 2 and not copy button, so nothing will happen, right? And if I click on OK, the control disappeared. So if I click it again the control will open. If I click on OK, the control will disappear. Let me close this, and let me immediately do one more thing. Message plus string message is equal to blank, and on the next line message is equal to message plus get text. Now one small change, only one small change, and now if I compile the program and run this, okay, there is nothing. Let me put that as Kolhapur. Let me click on copy. Now if I click the second time again, okay, I was expecting it should happen. I'll fix this. Now it is already 10 and 2. I'll see you in the lab session at 2:15. The important part is, I may not be able to share the URL. Use the same personal meeting room URL to join the lab session at 2:15. Okay, so we'll continue with our discussion. There are many things that I haven't discussed that I'll discuss in the lab session. So see you at the 2:15 slot. Use the same meeting URL to join. You can leave the meeting. I may not be able to share the link, but use the same URL to join at 2:15. You can leave the meeting, no problem.